Hello, everyone, and welcome to Andover High School for CTN's coverage of the Section 7 4A girls basketball quarterfinal between the number one seeded Andover Huskies and the number eight seed Coon Rapids Cardinals. Joey on Howie Shapiro sidelines, and Howie, a huge challenge for the underdog Cardinals coming in against the Andover team that has handled them twice so far this season and has hopes at making it to the state tournament for the second time in school history.
It's always tough to beat a team three times, but you know, you look at the situation Coon Rapids is in. They haven't won a game since the end of December. They've had some difficulty being consistent, and if they're going to beat Andover tonight, they're going to have to be consistent. They've played them tough in a half, but they haven't played them tough for two halves. That's what they're going to have to do tonight.
Well, they will need to get good production from all of their young star players, and that starts underneath with number 23, Kaylee Porsche.
Porsche comes in averaging a little over 12 points a contest, and she is going to be a key for the Cardinals because they want to certainly work the ball around the perimeter, but they want to get the ball down low to her. They feel they have a mismatch here as their biggest component against the Huskies tonight.
Well, and it's not that much of a mismatch because Jolene Danager on the other side, she can clean up the glass.
She definitely can, but she, most importantly, she's very good from outside. She's averaging over 15 points a game. In the first contest against Andover, she dropped 28 on the Cardinals. So Coach Peterson knows that this is a player they're going to have to be consistent with in terms of defending. They're going to have to know where she is on the court if they have an opportunity to win the game tonight.
Well, and in the matchup with the Cardinals that we did, she was held to just 7 points, but picked up 14 rebounds in that contest.
Yeah, she's very aggressive. You know, she plays the guard position, but she's very aggressive as well underneath, especially following shots that she misses. So the Cardinals defensively, they're going to have to know that, have to limit opportunities for the Huskies tonight if they want to win this contest.
Porish ready to jump against Amanda D'Agostino. And this game underway as Porish wins the tip, gets it back to Morehouse. Morehouse runs into some trouble in a double team. Ball comes loose. Carly Anderson tracking it down and able to recover for the Cardinals.
Well, you're gonna see Andover, Joe, defensively. They're gonna pressure.
Porish in the post, had some trouble, gets it down to Siner. Siner got some contact but no call as the ball went up in the air. Danager running the floor the other way. Hands it off to D'Agostino. Left side, back up top for Hostia. This is Danager with the left hand. D'Agostino working against Porish, down into the corner for Arness. Arness has it poked away by Mackenzie Wilkins out of bounds, and it'll stay in Andover basketball. In the game that we did, it was a two-point game until late in the first half when Andover went on an 11-0 run to end that first half. There's a look at his starters. Anderson, Morehouse, Wilkins, Siner, and Porsche for the Cardinals. Hauschild's, Dimer, Danager, D'Agostino, and Arness for the Cardinals. Drive to the lane, won't finish for D'Agostino. Wilkins the rebound. Siner gets it up court for Carly Anderson. Megan Morehouse with it now. Morehouse gets a pick, gets a little bit of room. Right side for Wilkins. Looking into the post, D'Agostino keeping a close eye on Kaylee Porish. Up top now is Megan Morehouse. She'll put it on the floor and try and drive against Danager. Lost the feet. Kept the ball alive, trying to push it back out to Wilkins. The Huskies come away with it. Danager on the run. Danager cuts through the defense. Shot is off the mark. Wilkins another rebound for the Cardinals. Wilkins, another one of those sophomores who has played a lot of minutes this season, but got a lot of time even as a freshman last year.
Well, turning the ball over and limiting opportunities. So far, Coon Rapids, they're doing a good job of limiting the opportunities. Unfortunately, they turned the ball over a couple times, opportunities on the offensive end. They're going to have to limit those, Joe.
D'Agostino called for the reach-in. First foul of the game goes against Andover. Morehouse looking to get it in. Finally finds Porish at the top of the lane. She drives and scores with the left hand. Coon Rapids on the board first.
That's what Coach Peterson needs from her squad, and that presence underneath by Porish. You can see she does a nice job of getting the basket for the points.
Huskies working it on the perimeter. Danager will take the three-pointer. It's off the mark. Long rebound tracked down by Hauschild. Back out to Danager.
A great hustle by Hauschild to get to keep that ball alive for the Huskies.
D'Agostino will kick it back out. Danager directing the offense for the Huskies. D'Agostino right side. Back up top to Danager. Tied up underneath as Morehouse gets in and ties up with Arness.
I was watching Morehouse defense. It was did a nice job with Arness. She kept her tight. She didn't let her get loose underneath. And then to get in that passing lane, almost an opportunity for a steal. Now she's going to pick up the infraction.
A little too much body there. First foul against Coon Rapids. Arness, right corner, back up top to D'Agostino. Back to Arness on the wing, back to D'Agostino. She'll bring it back up top. Danninger, watched by Morehouse. Puts it on the floor, spins in the lane, finds some room, draws a foul, and will go to the line to shoot two. This one's going to go against Kaylee Porich.
And that's what Jolene Danninger can do. She has such a nice job of finding some space underneath the basket and getting to the hole. That time she didn't get a shot to drop, but an opportunity to earn some points from the stripe. And Joe, foul situations too are going to be important, especially for Coon Rapids tonight.
Danninger hits the first, gets Andover on the board. And she hits them both. Inbound goes to Carly Anderson. Full court pressure from the Huskies. Cross court pass breaks it to Morehouse. Now Wilkins in the front court. Cross to Siner. Siner quickly draws the double team. And Danninger got there a little late. She'll pick up the foul. Can't get away with much as we get to the playoffs. And you get three striped shirts on the court.
Both players have a foul apiece in Porsche and Danninger, and those are the two players that, respectively, that both coaches want to make sure they stay in this contest.
Anderson to Porsche inside. Good defense coming over the top by Cassie Hofschild to force the turnover.
Well, they know, the Huskies, the Cardinals are going to want to work the ball underneath. So they did a nice job of collapsing inside of Porsche. They're going to try and get that underneath.
Underneath it goes. Hofschild will kick it back out. Danninger, a long three from the top of the key, and she buried it.
Yeah, that's why she's so dangerous at this point. Is that, you know, you get her an opportunity alone at the top of the key like that, and she can hit from the perimeter.
And the Cardinals turn it right back over. D'Agostino on the run for Andover. She'll dish underneath. Arness will score.
Yeah, pretty play. And then Arness just all alone the side of the basket. Coach Pearson's going to call a timeout. 7-2 lead for the Huskies, 14-21 remaining in the opening half.
And we talked to Coach Peterson about this before the contest. One of the big problems with a very young team is that they tend to get a little bit worried a little bit too early. When they don't need to panic, they start to panic, turn the ball over, and things kind of snowball and get worse from there.
Yeah, you know, they force things, and that's exactly what Coach Peterson is trying to avoid. You cannot force a situation in. This is too good a basketball team in an Andover to be able to try and force passes into small spots.
There's a look at the finish. Nice feed from D'Agostino and an easy basket for Ariel Arness. Again, full court pressure. Marina Nyberg into the game for the first time for the Cardinals. Gets it to Anderson. High post for Porish. She's going to drive, kicks it out. Siner from just inside the line. Wilkins battled, kept it in, but it went right to Cassie Hofschild. Long pass picked off by Carly Anderson. Anderson needs to wait for help. Good job by Andover to hustle back. Had five defenders back as Anderson got to the front court for Coon Rapids. Wilkins' pass is blocked, taken away by D'Agostino.
Again, they tried to move the ball inside, but there were too many dark jerseys there to force a pass. And you saw, we were talking about forcing things inside, in between a couple of defenders, not going to get it done.
D'Agostino, watched closely by Porish, will put it on the floor. And now drive to the lane, but misses everything. Siner is there for the rebound.
Yeah, and again, she did a nice job of getting through the defense. Unfortunately for her, couldn't get her shot to fall, but good chance there.
Mackenzie Wilkins out near midcourt, right or left side for Marina Nyberg. Siner trying to find room inside. Spinning shot is going to hang up there and stop. Wow.
You get like 1 point for that?
That'd be a jump ball, and the Cardinals will keep it.
They're going to have to get somebody out of the stands. Maybe Coach Abort can come down. Oh, there we go. Nice. Assistant coach from the Andover Husky squad. Commented about your shirt. You guys are wearing the same color today.
Can't help it when people got style.
They got style, absolutely. You got style, Joe Young.
Porish spins underneath. Hers won't fall either. Morehouse the rebound. Kicks it out to Seinert. Seinert drives, throws it up. Misses the mark, and Porish is going to be called for the push.
That's
going
two.
After the rebound, and that is her second.
Yeah, that's a tough situation. She'll probably come out of the contest. Aaron Jenkins is looking to come in, and yes, Porsche will sit down with two persons. The last thing, Joe, that Coon Rapids needs at this point is to have her in foul trouble.
And it was a pretty easy call as she pushed DeAndra Mullins as she tried to go for that loose ball. Daninger moves it right side for Dimer. Dimer to Daninger on the left side. Looking for baseline room. Kicks it out. Up top, Hochschild. Dimer on the left. Up top for Dimer for three. That won't hit. Seinert tips, recovered by Wilkins. Mackenzie Wilkins trying to run the floor against Daninger. Double team comes. Pass nearly got away from Wilkins. Nyberg able to recover. Morehouse gets it to Jenkins in the high post. Out for Seinert. Seinert to Nyberg up top. She'll take the three. That one won't fall. Rebound by D'Agostino. Hochschild hit the floor hard, but able to get back up and come up court.
You know, they're going to need Nyberg as one of the contributors off the bench to spark this Cardinal team. You know, she was a starter earlier in the season, but has been relegated to the bench as of late. And she can score when she gets an opportunity.
Hochschild working against Seinert, able to draw the foul, gets in line and shoot two.
That'll be foul number four on the Cardinals as a team. Seinert's first.
Hard off the back iron. Lead for Andover sits at 7-2. Coon Rapids scored the first points of the game, have been silent since.
Wilkins and Anderson back in for Coon Rapids.
Hochschild able to hit 1-2.
Alyssa Hosted in for Andover off the bench.
Nyberg, Jenkins, pull-up jumper is good.
Well, you talked about it. They've been silent after scoring that first bucket. They needed those points there.
Mullins in the lane, kicking it out to the corner. Tipped away out of bounds by the Cardinals. Mullins in up top for Haley Dimer. Poked away by Nyberg, but right to D'Agostino. Dimer in the corner, another three attempt. This one in and out. Rebound, Cardinals trying to save it, still loose. Controlled now by Carly Anderson. Cuts back against the grain, and she carried.
The Cardinals are fortunate, Joe, that they're only trailing by four. Andover's had some nice looks at the basket, haven't gotten their shots to fall. And just that 8-4 situation now for Coon Rapids. They have to continue to tighten up on defense and get stops.
Erica Thielen now into the game. She actually sang the national anthem in a very nice rendition.
Yes, really nice.
To start tonight's contest. D'Agostino driving. She draws the foul.
Call that on Wilkins or Morehouse?
I think it's going to go against Morehouse.
Yep.
That'll be number five against Coon Rapids. Still a little less than 11 minutes remaining in this first half. A lot of time to play.
Well, Cardinals are shuffling in players off the bench. Wilkins, who had just come in for Seinert. Seinert now back into the contest.
Dimer working against Marina Nyberg. Mullins will take a three from the top of the key. That won't fall. The rebound by Morehouse. Morehouse had it stripped right back to Mullins.
Yeah, quick hands that time by the Husky defense, able to take that one away from Morehouse and give him the back of the ball for the opportunity.
Another three-pointer on the way, but missing everything for Danninger. She'll get it back at the top of the key. Danninger, nice crossover to get inside. That shot won't fall either. Rebound tipped around, finally controlled by Cheyenne Siner.
Again, another look underneath for Andover that didn't fall.
Mullins, great job getting into the passing lane and stealing that one away. Danninger behind the defense, and there's no question that was a foul.
Yeah, we heard that with our headphones. Call that on Carly Anderson for the slap on the arm. Sixth team foul against the Cardinals.
Going to put a good shooter at the free throw line for Andover.
Not the shooter you want put on the line. Nicole Frazier in for Coon Rapids.
Danninger hits one of two, and Frazier can't track down the rebound in the corner. It'll be Andover basketball.
Gabrielle Garcia in for Andover. Wilkins back in now, this time for Jenkins for Coon Rapids.
Good movement on the perimeter for Andover. In the left corner is Danninger. Back up top to Mullins. Right side for Hosted. Here's Mullins with it. She'll put it on the floor and look to the lane. Kicks it back out. Hosted, a little ball fake, and now backs out. Left side, Mullins to the paint. Spins back to her right. Throws it up. Won't hit. Feeling the rebound. And that's going to be an offensive foul as she lowered the shoulder.
She did. And again, a couple of looks that time for the Huskies, not getting things to drop. Cardinals just trailing by five with 9:36 remaining in the opening half. That is the third team foul on Andover. Jessica Kohler coming in for Coon Rapids. And she's another one that has a nice shot from the perimeter, and we'll see if they can get her involved a little bit from outside.
They will get it to her in the corner. Three-pointer is good, and it's a two-point game.
Now, that was a nice spark off the bench for Coon Rapids. As, you know, we've seen games where Kohler's been hot from that position, and she is able to drop that one there.
Mullins in the post. Kicks it out. Three-pointer for Hosted won't fall. Wilkins, the rebound. Nyberg will run up court. Nyberg runs into traffic. Shot comes up short. Mullins long down court for Hosted. And she is fouled and will go to the line to shoot two. And with that, the Huskies will be in the bonus the rest of the way.
Yeah, and they'll call that one on Wilkins. Again, a nice outlet pass down, giving her an opportunity to get the 2 points, but now she'll have to earn them from the stripe. Look close to a lot of ball there.
I was going to say there. Not that I would ever question an official.
No, of course not, and not that you're a homer either. But.
Correct. But it did look as if she got quite a bit of basketball on that.
I thought she had ball before she had any contact on the body, but.
Hosted able to hit one of two. It's 10-7 the lead. Well, and Mackenzie Wilkins, I think, we saw a little bit of her last year as a freshman. We knew she would get some playing time.
Yep.
We expected really big things from Nyberg and Porish because of how much they played as freshmen last year. And I think Nyberg has been one of the greatest surprises, pleasant surprises for the Cardinals this year. I really like the way her game has come along. She does a lot of things very well. Kohler trying to kick it out to the other side of the lane, and the Cardinals can't control it. It's out of bounds, and a turnover back to Andover. Hauschild into the front court, hands it off for Danninger on the floor. Garcia back to Hauschild, trying to get it back to D'Agostino, and recovers, but not quite. That'll be and over and back.
Well, good hustle by Wilkins to force that, because she came up to challenge.
Mm-hmm. Nyberg gets it into Cheyenne Siner, working against Hochschild, right side. Gets the screen from Porish. Nice little pick and roll. Porish can't finish. Able to get her own rebound, just rip it away from D'Agostino. Back up top for Carly Anderson. Left side for Wilkins. Wilkins running, finding room and scoring off the glass.
Smart move, uses her body to field, to shield the defender and able to get the up and in. 1 point lead now for the Huskies with 7:48 remaining.
Garcia spins to the left hand and scores.
Again, you see the Huskies pressure on defense. They love to do that. They love to give teams trouble getting that ball over the midline.
The pass was a little bit behind, batted away by Hochschild, recovered by Garcia. D'Agostino into the corner for Danninger. Nice spin move to find room and then blocked away by Porish out of bounds.
Yeah, a beautiful move to create space, but Porish playing with two fouls right there. Get a block. Danninger coming out of the ball game.
Well, the best part about this season for the Coon Rapids team is the amount of youth.
Yes.
Only a couple of seniors, and definitely they've been a big part. Three-pointer is good for Gabriela Garcia.
Yeah, and that's a big three. That increases the lead to six now. Cardinals had cut it down to one. And now the pressure defensively looking to pay off for the Huskies.
Nyberg finds room to Porish at the back door, and she'll score off the glass.
Yeah, Nyberg did a nice job of drawing two defenders to her, leaving Kaylee Porish alone there, as Wilkins is going to pick up another foul. It'll be her second, eighth on the Cardinals.
D'Agostino will go to the line for a 1-1. Wilkins will catch a breather as Morehouse and Jenkins check in. Yeah, but you talk about the youth. You talk about Wilkins, Porish, Nyberg, all sophomores. Front end of the 1-1 is off the mark. Mullins, the long rebound. You talk about Carly Anderson, a junior.
We have three seniors on this roster in Morehouse, Kohler, and Siner.
A miss in close again. Nyberg, the rebound, will run it down court. Pulls up for the 15-footer. Misses off the back iron, the rebound. Is by Ariel Arness.
Coach Peterson won't be disappointed with that offer by Nyberg, because she had a nice look. She had space. She just didn't get it to drop.
Dimer, a long two, won't fall. Tipped out of bounds by Porish, and it'll be an Andover basketball. Nicole Frazier, we've seen a lot of, also a sophomore. Brianna Clark has had a fair amount of playing time, a junior. Aaron Jenkins, a junior. So a lot of good things that will be coming back for Coon Rapids next season.
Yeah, and you look at this roster and in Andover, they've got some quality young players. A player like Erica Thielen coming in, just a sophomore, a 6-foot sophomore, getting some opportunity here, some minutes.
Good hustle by Haley Dimer. Got a hand in on the pass, and it's out off of Frazier and a turnover to the Huskies.
Again, just being quick, getting to the ball.
Three-pointer for Hochschild is good.
That was a nice shot from the outside. That increases the lead now to seven.
Third three-pointer of this first half for the Andover Huskies. Foul is just the fourth against Andover. Will be the second, though, against young Erica Thielen. Jenkins, left side for Siner, puts it on the floor to Nicole Frazier. Got the pick from Porish, a little pick and roll, but the pass got away, and Andover comes away with it. Danninger on the run. Another three-pointer, this one off the mark, but Danninger will get the long rebound.
Yeah, it was a fortunate bounce out to Danninger for her to be able to keep possession.
Mullins' long two is good. Andover's lead is 20 to 11.
Andover's starting to pull away here as we at the five-minute mark of the first half. Cardinals are going to call a timeout again here, trailing by nine. And you know, and the biggest thing is for Coach Peterson and her staff, and of course the players, is not let this lead get out of hand. We saw them go on that run, as you talked about.
Well, the Cardinals, they really need a run of their own to get back into this. We talk about basketball all the time being a game of runs.
Yep, absolutely.
Got to have some positives to go with the negatives in order to stay competitive.
Well, everything's positive and nothing is negative about sports night every Monday night. Not much longer on Monday night, though. We will be switching to Tuesdays come spring.
We will. I looked at the initial. Monday's show most likely going to be, well, no question about it. Monday will be the season review. Because I believe the semifinal round is Saturday, correct?
Yeah, I believe so.
And in order to keep the season alive, if the Cardinals were able to win tonight and Saturday, we would push the review show back a week.
Right.
So
I hope it happens.
It's not a definite, but it's most likely going to be the review show of the winter season next Monday. And I did look ahead into the schedule, and it looks like we're actually going to open the spring season with a Monday show and then move to Tuesdays.
All right. Well, you know, and of course, our old habits die hard.
And of course, springs are so much fun. They're
yes.
so interesting because everything is weather permitting.
Always. Spring, yeah, you just don't know.
Mullins, long three-pointer. This one will not roll home. Siner the rebound. Wilkins, pressured, gets it across court to Carly Anderson for three. That misses the mark, and it's out of bounds to Andover.
Getting the air ball chance from the student section right, literally right behind us and next to
and
us.
And next to us.
Yeah.
You fit right in.
I do. I'm just young at heart.
Fit right in.
Brings back those memories of Stillwater football.
All right. Well, that was the parent section.
It was right in the section.
Yeah, but I mean, it's hard to tell there's any age gap between you and the
That's
young man
true.
Sitting next to you.
That's true. Certainly not mentally.
No, he's much older than you.
Much.
Much more mature than you
and experienced than I.
Danninger right side, and now Mullins. Up top, Dimer, left side, Hofschild. Puts it on the floor, watched by Siner, left side for Mullins. Cross court, a little too much on that. That one's right to Kaylee Porish on the Coon Rapids bench.
There's head coach Peterson. Chipping a chair, just getting an opportunity to see if they can stay with the Huskies and give themselves an opportunity to advance.
Double team comes. Siner able to get it ahead to Carly Anderson. Kohler from the left corner this time. This time she misses. And the Huskies recover the rebound. Garcia for three at the other end. She just gets the front of the rim. Kohler the rebound.
Oh, it's double dribble. She had to know she couldn't. She had to pick up that dribble. She had to have known that she needed to get rid of the basketball. But unfortunately,
she thought that the defender had gotten a hand in on the ball, and that's not the way the referee
nope.
saw it. Another three-pointer is good for Danninger. Last 8 points for Andover, a pair of three-pointers and Mullins' long two. They like to shoot from the perimeter.
They do, and you can see when they're successful, able to build up this lead. Now
three of their last 4 baskets from beyond the arc. 4 three-pointers in this half. And their lead has grown to 12. Steiner's shot won't fall. A save along the baseline by Alyssa Hostad.
Well, I like the thought by Steiner. She did create some space for herself.
Danninger up top, will pump fake, drives inside. Floater over Porish won't fall. Nyberg can't control, but Anderson is there to recover. Wilkins running the right wing. Gets down low, kicks it out to Porish, batted away and stolen by Haley Dimer.
Haley Dimer did a nice job of just making sure she was going to give trouble to Porish catching that
Danninger pass. Danninger another three. This time it's not going to go. Wilkins had the rebound. It got away. Hostad came up with it. She's fouled. She'll go to the line to shoot a 1-1.
They call that on Steiner, I believe.
You are correct.
That'll be her second. 9th on
so
the Cardinals.
So astute.
Well, you know,
Shapiro.
It was a good
so
guess.
Astute.
It was 1 of 2, so I had a 50% chance, and I chose correctly.
For once. First one's hard off the back iron, but D'Agostino the rebound. She'll bring it back to the top. Working against Wilkins, finds room in the lane and scores off the glass.
Another timeout called by Coon Rapids. Now they're down by 14 with a little under 2 minutes remaining in the half. And again, a nice move for the Huskies to get record that basket and increase this lead.
Well, it's a 10-0 run. And a 15-2 run since it was a 1-point game. And that's what it comes down to.
Yep.
Cardinals cut it back, got it close, and since have lost all control.
Well, Coach Belchner certainly has to be pleased so far with the way his team is playing.
I'm sure he likes it.
Oh, perfect. Perfect segue.
That's right. Like us on Facebook, CTN Studios on Facebook. What a shock. And Shapiro's on Facebook.
I am on Facebook.
Evidently, everyone knows. They show it on social media that everyone likes Shapiro. Wilkins' 17-footer won't go. Porish had the rebound, but it was poked away. Anderson got it back to Steiner. Her shot won't fall. Got her own rebound. Got it to Porish. Her shot won't fall, and Garcia has the rebound. Under 90 seconds remaining in the first half. Dimer kicks it out. Garcia lost the handle, and Wilkins takes it away.
Nice job. Steiner got a hand in there.
Wilkins able to score and at least end that long Andover run. Danninger somehow got between a couple of defenders, but the shot won't go, and then the Cardinals just throw it away. Miscommunication.
Steiner threw it behind Wilkins.
Under a minute remaining first half, and over a 25-13 lead. Wow, nice strip by Megan Morehouse. Just took that one away from Jolene Danninger. Steiner finds a way in and scores.
Yeah, and again, just good control by Steiner. Cuts the lead to 10.
Drive by D'Agostino the other way for the answer.
That time they let D'Agostino come in. And certainly Porsche has to be concerned playing with two. Does not want to pick up that third before the end of this first half. Now there's a turnover by the Cardinals.
Pass down court. Mullins recovers in the corner. Danninger for three. It's good.
Now that's how you put it away. Increase that lead now to 15, the break.
Morehouse to Wilkins from 17 foot. It comes up short. Rebound underneath. Porish rips it away, but won't be able to do anything before the buzzer sounds and sends this one to the half. The Huskies with a comfortable 30-15 lead as we reach the break. We'll take a short break and be back with first half stats and highlights after this. You're watching Girls High School Basketball Section Quarterfinals on CTA.
Oh, hi. I'm TV's Howie Shapiro. And when I'm not announcing CTN sports broadcasts with my sidekick, Joe Yen, I'm watching all the other great programs on the CTN Studios YouTube page. There's news stories, great local events, and even full games. You can even watch on any smart device with a YouTube app. Whether that's your phone or a tablet, you can watch CTN's great programming wherever and whenever you want. You can even watch CTN's event coverage live. So no matter where you are, you can share in all the excitement. CTN Studios, building community through cable.
Back at Andover High School, the Huskies a 30-15 lead as we reach the half of this Section 7-4A quarterfinal. It was a good, tight ball game for the first half of the first half, but Andover really took control down the stretch.
They really did, and they did a nice job of hitting from beyond the arc, Joe, and that's something that really built this lead up for the Huskies. Cardinals in early, and they had some opportunities because Andover was having difficulty shooting from the outside, as you see Jessica Kohler coming into the game and dropping her first shot attempt. But Cardinals in the second half, Joe, certainly what they're going to have to do is they're going to have to create turnovers, and they're going to have to make sure they hit their shots, and easier said than done.
Well, you mentioned the perimeter shooting, 5 3-pointers for Andover in that first half, and that is really the difference in the game. Half of their points from beyond the arc, but it was a 10-9 ball game, so the Cardinals were outscored 20-6 after that point.
Yeah, and again, down by 15, it's obviously a tough hole to dig out of. They were trailing.
Not impossible.
No, they were trailing Andover earlier in the season and had a pretty good second half, and that's what they're going to have to do. But the biggest thing is they're going to have to limit opportunities from the Huskies. They're going to have to continue to watch Jolene Dellinger and opportunities, look at some other players and try and limit one-chance opportunities for the Huskies.
Yeah, Dellinger had 3 of their 5 3-pointers, but definitely not the only dangerous shooter on the home team.
Well, she has 12 points. You look at Kaylee Porsche coming in playing with 2 personals, only 4 points so far in the evening. So the Huskies are doing a good job defensively on her, limiting her ability from underneath the basket.
Well, they are so fast, so aggressive on defense. The Cardinals, really, you can see, I mean, as soon as the ball moves, Andover's got defense in place.
There's Coach Belchner, and again, he has to be pleased with the 15-point lead at the break. And, you know, looking his side, they continue to do what Andover is doing, play pressure defense, play tough, get in the passing lanes, and then convert when you steal the when you get the turnover from Coon Rapids.
Huskies start the second half with the ball and a big lead. Dimer into the front court, watched by Marina Nyberg. Dellinger at the top of the key, a 3 is good.
Yeah, not the way Coon Rapids wanted the second half to start. And again, we talked about limiting her opportunities, and as she comes out, she's very dangerous from the perimeter, and she shows you why right there.
Turnover. Pressure defense forces the travel and the turnover by Coon Rapids. Dimer into the front court, sets up right side. Again, Dellinger at the top of the key, this time to D'Agostino on the left. She'll put it on the floor, hand it out to Hofstra. Into the corner, Arness. Baseline jumper won't fall, Wilkins the rebound.
Yeah, nice job by Wilkins to get up and get that board.
She's
after the miss.
Again, that's what we were talking about in the first half. She does so many things well, and rebounding is definitely one of them. The shot by Nyberg is short, a scramble on the floor for the rebound. And we're going to have D'Agostino getting it, but they travel. So it'll be Coon Rapids basketball. Hey, Inbound pass kicked away by the Huskies.
Hofstra getting a foot on the ball.
Wilkins working against Hofstra, finds some room to the baseline, and she'll get a foul. Go to line and shoot two. That's another thing. Cardinals did not get to the charity stripe a single time in the first half. Wilkins able to hit them both. She's got 6 points to lead the Cardinals. D'Agostino back out, Hofschild, now Dimer and Arnaz on the right side. Up top, D'Agostino. Back to Arnaz. Inside, Hofschild working against Jenkins, finds Danager in the lane. She lost the handle but recovered. Back out, D'Agostino. Into the paint, kicks it out. Three-pointer is no good. But a foul is going to be underneath, away from the ball.
See, they called that
on. Huskies will keep it. It's going to go against Marina
Nyber. Yep.
Her first.
Each team has a foul here so far in the second half early on. Call Morehouse, I think, for the reach in.
He's going to put Danager at the line to shoot two.
That's the third personal on Morehouse.
Danager misses the first, a little flat. Make the second.
Over her average with 16-10 remaining in the contest. A turnover by the Cardinals.
Hofschild kicks it out. Danager thought about this shot, now goes to the lane. Throws this one up with the left hand, and it finally rolls in.
This one didn't stay up there that time.
I thought it was going to.
I thought so as well. Timeout Coon Rapids is. The Cardinals continue to fall in a hole.
And it's been all Jolene Danager for the Huskies so far here in the second half.
Yeah, just a nice job of creating a little space, getting the shot up, and then getting that little nice roll bounce
for it,
off the back of the rim.
It. Okay, it is it.
Yeah, it is it. It took a couple of bounces.
Cheerleaders getting the home crowd into it. Of course, it helps that their team up 19.
Yeah, everybody's all smiles here in the student section because they're so close to Joe Young.
Oh, now they've done it.
Oh, they just knocked our replay off.
Enough that our monitor's
gone. No signal. They stomped it.
That's it.
They stomped the signal out of it. Maybe somebody had. Just hit it. Hit the monitor. It seems to work.
I just bent some things. Yeah, you know. Push some things
here,
around.
Here, put some of this gum. There we
go.
There
we go. There is always a logical solution.
Yes. You jiggle enough wires.
Unless there's an illogical one. Morehouse's pass tipped away. D'Agostino on the break. And they stripped it away. But it'll stay Andover basketball.
And yeah, no contact there. A couple of Cardinal defenders coming down court. with D'Agostino.
D'Agostino in the corner. Up top, tried to cut back, lost the handle. Morehouse recovers for Coon Rapids. Siner kicks it out. Wilkins pumps, puts it on the floor, and now in some trouble, needs some help. Hands off to Nyberg. Nyberg has a little bit of room. Her shot's going to come up short. Rebound by Dimer.
Well, she got around the defender, just did not get enough elevation on the shot.
Three-pointer by Danninger is good.
Yeah, she's dangerous from outside. She has 21 already, Joe. 21 of the 39 points for Andover.
And by the way, she's just a sophomore.
Yeah.
She's a decent ball player.
She's good. Yeah, she definitely is good. Yeah,
4 3-pointers in the contest. And I'd say she's probably only missed, she's missed at least one, and maybe two. But she's shooting pretty high percentage from beyond the arc. Lead has grown to 22 for the Andover Huskies, the top seed. Wilkins, nice job finding some room. Tried to kick it out to Frazier. The pass didn't quite get there quick enough. He's able to recover. Wilkins back in the corner. Her pass tipped and a race for it. And we're going to have a foul against Marina Nyberg.
That'll be Nyberg's second. Coon Rapids third as a team. You know, I want to give a shout out to the boys basketball player Timmy Wynn for making all conference. He certainly had a good season and did a lot to keep that team on his back.
As best he could, as the team went through so many changes this season, but what a way to finish. That was one of the most vicious picks ever, and Carly Anderson on the floor in a little bit of pain.
Yeah, she's
3-pointer off the mark. And I mean, she ran into a wall named Erica Thielitt.
Yeah, she really
and
did.
She hit the ground hard.
Nyberg's going to check in, but let's just hope she's okay. We'll see it again. Oh, she took an elbow. See another look at this. Now watch. Oh yeah, she took a hard shot from Thielen.
Yeah, the fever movement.
Yeah.
That would make it illegal.
Yes, it would.
But not the way the referee saw it. And again, she ran into Erica Thielen. We talked about it, 6 foot. Carly Anderson is not a 6-footer.
No, she's definitely not.
Well, and holding her head, that's never a good sign.
That's not good. Hope she's okay. She gets to her feet. Having a tough time staying on her feet.
So back to the bench and back to action. The Cardinals do have the ball after the missed 3-pointer. Nyberg, an open look for three. Won't get it to go. Rebound tipped around, controlled by D'Agostino.
Going to get a couple of black jerseys off that miss, and D'Agostino does a nice job of getting that rebound.
Danninger into the corner for Garcia. Back up top to Mullins. Underneath from the foul.
Coach Peters is not happy with that defensive effort from her club. Bringing Siner over to the sideline for a quick message.
D'Agostino misses the first. And she misses them both. Thielen tracks down the rebound in between two defenders. And a smart timeout by the Andover bench.
Yeah, but Thielen
she
smartly
did,
put it off the leg of the Cardinal.
Off of a Cardinal leg out of bounds.
But Coach Belcher thought better just call that timeout, keep possession.
It was two smart plays in
yes,
one.
Yes, absolutely.
A smart timeout, but a smart heads-up play by the sophomore.
Action 39-17 lead for Andover, 13-21 remaining in the contest and remaining in the season for one of these two teams. Cardinals have a way to go to dig out of this hole.
Thielen, an open look from 15 feet. She drains it. She's the first to score a point for Andover that is not wearing number 15.
Well, they did a nice job of working the ball around the perimeter and finding Thielen at the free throw line.
Well, they're not quite sure what the strategy is with the Cardinals playing defense with four. Sending one down court.
Wilkins in and Porsche out.
Garcia at the top of the key for Andover. Left side, tipped away out of bounds by Frazier.
Nicole Frazier getting in that passing lane, trying to get the turnover. Morehouse lead, in.
The lead is 24 for the Huskies, 12:40 to play. Into Garcia, then to Daninger in the corner. Great ball movement again. Garcia down low. She's fouled by Wilkins. She'll go to the line and shoot two.
Wilkins trying to prevent that look from underneath. Gabby Garcia at the line.
Gabby Garcia, that's a good name.
Yep.
I don't know though. I think I like the full name, Gabriella Garcia.
Yep.
It's got a great ring to it.
It does.
Good sports name. She hits both from the free throw line. Cardinals held to just 2 points so far in this second half. Thielen reaches in, gets that steal. Daninger will slow things down. Mullins. Right side from Meester, back up top to Daninger. Nice pass, Garcia for three, it's short. Rebound by Morehouse, she's fouled by Garcia.
That'll be just the second team foul on the Huskies here in the second half. Cardinals with five.
Nice basketball team,
yep,
no question.
Yep, absolutely. Came in at 16-10 on the season.
How'd they do against Elk River?
We'll find that out.
I
have that information.
Elk River team was
very
nice move by Mackenzie Wilkins. Stepped through a couple of defenders and earned that basket.
Yes,
Another three-point attempt for Danninger. Won't go. Garcia was blocked by Wilkins. A scramble on the floor, the tie-up, and the possession arrow will favor Coon Rapids.
Well, the answer to your question is that they played them at home and they lost by six. And they finished with them on the road and they lost by 10. So they did lose to the Elks twice.
Yeah, the Elks are a really good basketball team, but just based on what I've seen here tonight, I imagine that it would be a fun contest. I think Elk River a little stronger presence underneath.
Yeah, they've got a
lot of size, and Jenkins travel.
They do. They have a 6'2 and a 6'1 player.
But we saw they have a great perimeter game as well.
Yep, they do. They're really well-coached all-around squad.
I like this basketball team, though. God, the hustle from this team has been impressive.
Well, that's what they pride themselves is pressuring. Hustle defense, pressuring their opponents.
Hochschild lost it, but it's out off of Coon Rapids.
Yeah, Elk River, obviously they won the North Division. They're 22-3 overall, Joe, on the season. They're 11-0 in the conference.
That's pretty decent.
Yeah, that's pretty good. It's pretty good stuff.
And if I remember right, their losses came to some really good basketball programs. Jenkins got the rebound, punched away out of bounds. It'll stay Cardinal ball.
You see the clock, 10:43 remaining in this contest, 43-19 in favor of the Huskies on their home court.
Brianna Clark into the game. She'll bring it up court for the Cardinals. Another young player that showed a little bit of promise in the time she's had on the floor.
And you can see the speed of Marina Nyberg. She does possess that as she tried to gain the corner.
Gets the foul and gets herself to the free throw line. And she'll get the roll.
23-point lead for the Huskies.
And Nyberg able to hit them both. Well, if nothing else, the Cardinals, once they've gotten to the free throw line, have done well.
They have.
They're 4-for-4. Got to have something to hang your hat on.
Silver lining, absolutely.
Pull up for Hostad is short, but she got the foul. It's going to go against Porish. It'll be her third. Oh, that was Meester, excuse me. Meester hits the first. And she hits them both very cleanly.
We always talk about how important points from the stripe are. Winning teams are successful from the charity stripe.
Clark in the corner tried to force it underneath, tipped away out of bounds by the Huskies.
Returning for the Huskies, number 13, Haley Fever.
D'Agostino and Deemer back in the lineup for the Huskies.
Pull-up jumper for Wilkins is short. D'Agostino the rebound. Deemer right side, back to D'Agostino. Hochschild on the right. Left side for Arness. Deemer working against Nyberg, and Nyberg's going to pick up a foul.
That'll be her third. That'll be the seventh team foul on the Cardinals. Huskies, again, doing a nice job of staying out of foul trouble both halves. Just three personals on the Huskies here in half number two.
And the Huskies in the bonus the rest of the way. Haley Deemer at the free throw line. For a 1-1, she misses the front end. Porish the rebound. Clark bobbled but recovers the pass. Wilkins left side for Nyberg. Finds some room, shot comes up short. D'Agostino the rebound. Pass is tipped, Nyberg recovers. Nyberg underneath will score.
Yeah, good hustle by Marina Nyberg to realize where that ball was on the floor and she's able to put it up and in. Cardinals knock that attempt out of bounds. Stay with the Huskies.
Hotschild will wait for help, tipped away out of bounds. Pass to the corner, three-pointer is off the mark for Hostad, tipped away out of bounds. It'll be Coon Rapids basketball. Nyberg finds some room and scores off the glass.
Yeah, good job, under control, able to get the bucket. Nyberg with six.
And it's the last 6 points for the Cardinals. D'Agostino to Hostad. And another foul on Nyberg.
Yeah, that's going
to
be her fourth. You know, again, that situation, she's playing well here tonight, and she will not stay in the contest. Signer coming in. You know, and that's a young player that this team will count on for the next few years. She got some early minutes on the starting and coming off the bench, contributing well.
One more.
Hostad hits the first. And she hits them both.
Danninger back in for Andover.
Signer to Wilkins in the paint. Out to Kohler for three. That one's off the back of the rim. Long rebound by Hostad. Porish hustling.
Yeah, Porish has to be careful as well.
She's going to be the one drawing the foul as she was bumped off it by Hostad.
Just the fourth team
foul. They're going to give it to D'Agostino instead.
There you see where the foul occurred. D'Agostino, her second. Team fourth.
Wilkins thought about the three there for a minute. All right, maybe not a full minute, but half
seemed
a second.
Seemed like a minute.
Nice look to Porish underneath, and she scores in the paint.
Well, that's what the Cardinals have been trying to do all night long, is that work the ball around the perimeter and find that opening underneath for Porish. That time it worked to perfection. Porish able to score. Just 6 points for her tonight. Six below her average.
They have done a very nice job. And of course, she's been in a little bit of foul trouble, so spent a fair amount of time on the bench.
Well, she just picked up her fourth.
Speaking of foul trouble.
Yep.
Deemer misses the front end of the 1-1. The rebound tracked down by Ruprecht. Mullins to D'Agostino. Long two is in and out. Rebound tipped out of bounds by Andover.
D'Agostino trying to get that rebound. Pushes it out of bounds.
Wilkins in the corner. Found room on the baseline. Draws the foul on Danninger. Going to be her second.
Team fifth. You're going to see it there. She's trying to gain the edge, and Danninger's going to pick up the foul.
Close to being a tie.
Yeah.
Porish turns towards the basket, can't get it to fall. Rebound controlled by Morehouse. Her pass tipped, recovered by Deemer. Danninger will bring it up court. Spinning against Morehouse, out to Mullins. Here's D'Agostino. D'Agostino drives. She's blocked but fouled. And we'll go to the line and shoot two.
Is that Wilkins or Porish? Yep, it's Wilkins. That'll be her fourth.
Might have to, these fouls continue, and they might have to pull Shapiro off the bench.
I have no eligibility.
Are you sure?
Yep.
Not to mention no athletic shoes.
And no athletic shoes and very little skill. So that would that wouldn't work.
I wasn't going to go there.
I went there.
Timeout on the floor.
.48-27 lead for the Huskies as the Cardinal season is winding down. Coach Peterson instructing her squad. There, oh, there's Crunch's third cousin on his mother's side.
Howie the Husky?
I don't know about Howie.
I do now.
Yeah.
From now on.
It's Howie the Husky.
Howie the Husky. Okay. Or is it Harry? They're not quite
more
sure.
Appropriate to be Harry.
He is definitely Harry.
Yeah, yeah.
But what his name is, we're not quite sure. Or her name. Could be her.
Yep.
Could be Holly the
Could
Husky.
Be Holly.
Or Harriet the Husky.
Now you're reaching. Or Heidi the Husky.
Could be Heidi.
All I know is that Brandon Ricker is a big fan of the Husky.
And we are all big fans of Mr. Ricker.
Oh, absolutely.
D'Agostino, ice in her veins as she drains that one after the timeout. Signer underneath gets the foul and will go to the line and shoot two.
And again, nice job moving it underneath to Signer, giving her the ability to get to the line, see if she can hit two. Just 2 points on the night for Cheyenne Signer.
First one is off to the left. And the second, a little bit off to the right. Thielen the rebound. Mullins across midcourt, back to Danninger. Into the corner for Deemer. Ruprecht, near corner. Mullins, Danninger, three-pointer is good.
Just so impressive. They do a nice job of working her open. And she's so dangerous from outside the arc.
Three-pointer on the other side, and the answer for Nyberg. Danninger drives the length of the court and scores.
Cardinals just gave up the defense there, allowing Danninger to go right down the lane. 26 points on the night.
Nyberg will put it on the floor, run past Mullins, and score off the glass.
Maria's had a nice second half. She has 11.
Danninger, another 3-point. This one's short. Thielen the rebound, tied up nicely by Morehouse underneath. Possession arrow, though, favoring.
Yes.
Over Huskies.
Now look at the nice job by Nyberg to gain the edge and get around the defense.
Well, and that was a mismatch. She felt it. She knew it.
She knew it. She knew she had the speed.
Once she put it on the floor, that first step, Mullins was beat. Thielen can't score underneath. Able to track down her own rebound. Tied up again by Morehouse.
Yeah, Cardinals get it this time.
And this time it will be Coon Rapids ball. Wilkins in the high post will back out, hand it off to Nyberg. Under 5 minutes remaining in the contest. Nyberg for three, it's good.
She's feeling it from outside. 14 on the night. Lead at 19.
Working the perimeter, open look for Ruprecht. She can't hit, feel it. Battling for the rebound, and she's fouled by Nyberg. And that'll be it for Marina Nyberg.
And she's been the best player on the floor for Coon Rapids tonight.
All of her scoring coming here in the second half.
Yeah, and she just pulls back and drops the three. We talked about her sophomore, 6 foot sophomore. Getting good time, good minutes off the bench.
Not able to hit the first.
One player.
Lisa Hosted checks back in for Andover. Thielen misses them both. Wilkins the rebound. The Wilkins got it. If she doesn't have double-digit rebounds, it's got to be close. Porish all alone at the back door will score.
Coach Belcher calling a timeout. Again,
it was a 10-2 drive for the Cardinals.
Well, Cardinals have
too little, too late.
Yeah, have made the second half, just the second half numbers close here. But you look at the big lead that Andover had in that first half, really limited what the Cardinals wanted to do, and took them out of their game plan.
Well, it was the end of the first half and the beginning of the second when the Huskies went on big runs and really opened up that lead for the last several minutes. Cardinals outscoring the Andover Huskies, but at one point the Huskies were up by, how high did they get it to, a 24-point lead?
Yeah, I think it was a 24-point lead at one point.
26-point lead. Yep. 43-17. 26 points was the greatest lead of the game for the Huskies.
.410 remaining in the contest.
Then Marina Nyberg started scoring.
Yeah, and unfortunately she has fouled out, which ends her season if the Cardinals don't mount the comeback.
Cardinals trying to bring a little full court pressure out of the timeout. The Huskies able to break it relatively quickly. Work in the perimeter, Danninger, Hauschild. In the corner, Arnest, Danninger, a long three. This one's going to come up a bit short. Nice job by Arnest to come in and steal away the rebound. Danninger back out to Arnest in the corner. Around the look for Hostad. That won't fall. Jenkins the rebound. Down court, Frazier can't handle the pass. Hostad will come away with it. Danninger another three. That one's short again. Rebound tracked down by Morehouse. Frazier in the corner for the Cardinals. Spins away from pressure. Pull-up jumper. Misses long. Hostad the rebound. Here's Danninger. Danninger running through traffic. Gets a foul on Wilkins and will go to the line to shoot two. That's going to be the end of the night for Mackenzie Wilkins.
And she does a nice job, does Danager, of just using her acceleration and getting a chance to cut through the defense. You see it there, just couldn't get the bucket, a little bit of bump from Wilkins, threw that shot off a bit.
Now that right there is a shooter's roll. That was a shooter's shot right there.
Yeah, she has 28 points. She scored 28 points earlier in the season against Coon Rapids.
Long two is good for Kohler. Orish pressuring on defense, and she's going to foul out as well.
Yeah, she'll fall out with 8 points on the night. Again, good job Andover defense to limit what Borsch has done here tonight.
At the line for the Huskies, number 11, Ariel Arnes, shooting two.
Arnes at the line to shoot two. And she'll hit the first. This is the second. Kohler there for the rebound. Signer back out to Frazier. Drives into the paint, draws the foul. She'll go to the line to shoot two.
Again, trying to get around that defense. Created the contact to get her to the line. There you see where the foul is. Just reach in. They call that one on Danager, I believe. That would be her third.
Frazier able to hit one and two.
Call that on Signer. Be her third.
D'Agostino at the line to shoot two, hits the first. And hits them both. Three-pointer from Kohler will roll home.
Got the friendly bounce on the backside of the rim. Kohler has 8.
Designer tips that one away out of bounds. 1:29 left on the clock. D'Agostino lost the handle. It'll be Coon Rapids basketball on the turnover.
Andover and St. Francis in the sectional championship for the boys tomorrow night. Grand Rapids boys lost to St. Francis to start their section.
Kohler, another three-pointer. That won't fall. Clark, the rebound. The follow won't go. Long rebound controlled by D'Agostino. Manager dribbling through the defense. Hands it off to D'Agostino. Mullins waits for pressure, gets it, and gets a foul from Kohler. 33 seconds left on the clock.
Just her first infraction of the evening for Kohler.
Mullins hits the first. And Mullins hits them both.
30 ticks remain.
And that will end the girls' basketball season and the entire winter sports season at Coon Rapids High School.
Yes, it will. It's our last game of the winter season. Boy, how time flies.
Start to think spring.
Think spring.
D'Agostino tips that one out of bounds. 10 tips remain. Danager will just dribble
off. Yes, she will.
And allow this clock to run out. And the Huskies move on with a 61-43 win.
Yeah, nice win for the Huskies. They controlled this contest from start to finish. Good effort by the Cardinals in the second half, but the lead was insurmountable at this point. They just couldn't get over that hump. And they lose by a score of 61-43.
And, they knew coming in it was going to be a tall task to try and knock off a top seed in a section quarterfinal. But they felt they had played pretty well against them the two times they played and knew they would have to get everything going right from the get-go. Started that way, but they allowed that run late in the first half and then again early in the second half. They really allowed Andover to get that great big lead.
It's a consistency thing for the Cardinals here. You know, they play consistent second half, but not a consistent first half. As you talked about, Andover came out in that first half and build up, or the second half and built their lead up. And then the Cardinals played well, and they did a nice job. I mean, they scored 15 at the break, and now ended up 43 for the game. It's just the fact that they couldn't get over that hump, and they turned the ball over too many times, and they allowed second and third opportunities for the Huskies.
And again, a very young team for Coon Rapids, just three seniors graduating, so a lot of returning experience next season. But that's going to do it for the 2014-2015 winter season of CTN Sports. The final score again, it's Andover 61, Coon Rapids 43. Want to thank everybody out there for joining us and continuing to support everything we do here at CTN. For the entire crew, including Howie Shapiro, I'm Joe Young. Say goodnight.